Okay, thank you to everyone for tuning in. We are here in round two of the Georgia AA state playoffs. Harlem Lady Bulldogs taking on Bleckley County Lady Royals. In the top half of the first inning. Two outs. Number 14, Emmy Meadows, senior outfielder for the Royals, up to bat. Freshman pitcher Amber Garrett on the mound, the Lady Bulldogs. It's Meadows, fouls off. First pitch she sees. Round number three. So in the top half of the first inning, it'll be Elizabeth Mathis leading off with a strikeout. Number two, Lindsay Dabbs, the ground out. And number 14, Amy Meadows, with a strikeout. So two strikeouts for Amber Garrett to start off the game.
I'd like to remind everybody to check out player360.org. You can see actually Amber Garrett and some strikeout action with our K counter.
That's right. That's right. Last week in game one, she had 13 strikeouts, and we put a little highlight reel together showcasing that. So you can check that out at player360.org.
She makes quick work of Bleckley County's offense. We are switching it up here, and looks like we're going to be able to see what Bleckley's got for us defensively.
Yeah, we'll go ahead and give you the lineups for Bleckley County. Batting first, number 10, the shortstop. That is Elizabeth Mathis. Batting second, number 2, center fielder Lindsay Dabbs. Batting third, number 14, left fielder Emmy Meadows. Batting fourth, cleanup, number 3, the pitcher is Joanna Knight. And batting fifth, number 8, the catcher, Taylor Little. Batting sixth, number 15, second baseman Leslie Holland. Batting seventh, number 20, the right fielder is Allie Keel. Batting eighth, number 1, first baseman is Kelsey Darcy. Batting ninth is number 5, designated player, so Cole Tomlinson. And number 19, the flex player, is Allison Collins. Leading off, taking a strike. Leading off for the Lady Bulldogs is number 9, Haley Mays. She's the right fielder. Batting second for the Lady Bulldogs is number 5, second baseman Abby Drake. Batting third is third baseman Lindsay Stokes, as Haley grounds to short and over the first in time for the out. Batting cleanup for the Bulldogs, number 13, pitcher Amber Garrett. Batting fifth, number 11, first baseman Kristen Rollins. Batting sixth, number 6, catcher Morgan Barton. Batting seventh, number 3, designated player Hannah Price. Batting eighth, number 1, the shortstop Tori Koss, as Abby Drake takes a strike. And batting ninth, number 4, center fielder Kristen Mullis. And their flex player out in left field, number 12, defensive specialist in the Apple.
Abby Drake swings hard, cuts it foul. Strike two, count 0-2. Hanging in there with another foul tip. Count remains 0-2. Ball caught in the outside corner on that one. Abby Drake will take it back to the dugout.
Much to the delight of the Bleckley County fans.
Yeah.
They've shown up today. Pretty good numbers. They've got a good visiting crowd here in round two of the state playoffs. Andy Stokes looks at a strike. Now, looks like the wind might be blowing out a little bit, blowing out in the center. So. Could see some fireworks this evening. William Stokes drills one to right center field, and just as I say so, Lindsey Stokes puts the Lady Bulldogs on board with a solo homer.
As her teammates come out to home plate to greet her. I was just about to say we might see a pretty hard defensive fought battle here, but Lindsey Stokes is answering back.
She got one. And got out of here in a hurry. Yeah, the right fielder took a couple steps and just stopped. They knew it was gone as soon as it went off the bat. Number 13, pitcher Amber Gear takes the ball in the dirt. Popped up, shallow center field, coming on center fielder, not in time to make the grab, and with the throw over the first, Emma Garrett reaches safely. Looks like she'll most likely get a pinch runner. It's going to be number 2, Mackenzie Hall, coming in to run for the pitcher. And we've got number 11, Kristen Lefty Rollins, at the plate, facing off against the Royals pitcher, which is number 3, Joanna Knight.
Ball outside, low.
We're watching Knight warm up, and looks like she's got a pretty good fastball as Rollins grounds back to the pitcher. Number the first for out, number 3. Looks like she's got a pretty good fastball. She was really humming it in there during pregame warm up, but looks like she's got a pretty good changeup working too. So.
Yeah, she's able to move that ball around the plate too. So definitely going to be seeing some better pitching from Bleckley County than what the Harlem Bulldogs, I think, have been used to so far.
Yeah, that's one thing about a state tournament, state playoffs. You know, each round, the further you go, the higher the level of competition that you see. See if we can get some stats on Bleckley County. What they've been up to this year? They are Region 4, and they have a 6-1 record in their region. Overall, 16-14, averaging 6.2 runs a game and averaging 5.4 defensively. So they've been giving up a few runs. So we'll see how this goes. I got a pregame prediction from Mr. Applin, left fielder's father. He thinks it's going to be first game 6-2 and second game 8-1.
All right.
So we'll see. We'll see how that goes. So it's going to be number three, the pitcher Joanna Knight, leading off things for the Royals in the top half of the second inning. The right-handed senior also plays some first base.
Ball low. Count 1-0. Inside corner on that one, it looked like. Count goes to 1-1. Amber Garrett really showing some versatility moving that ball around the plate.
She had her fooled on that one. Ball and two strikes. Slap attempt. Grounded foul. So number 8, the catcher, Taylor Little. And one pitch. Taken for a ball. Grounded, left side and through. And Lowe's going to reach for the single. Just out of the reach of third base Lindsay Stokes as she's trying it. Number 15, Leslie Holland. To the plate, the junior third baseman of the Royals. She shows bunt, pop, foul, and Stokes charging on the bunt. Not able to get back as the ball falls near the Bulldogs dugout. We are broadcasting live through our Ustream channel, Harlem Softball. We've put it on Netcast Sports. We have more than one channel as Browns back to the pitcher Andy Garrett over the first for the out. Rollins goes down to second for the pickoff count, but back safe. But it looks like we have embedded or put one of our other channels up on the on the Netcast Sports site right now. But
Right now it's being broadcast on Player 360 Live, but I've been told by our technical department that it will be switched back over to the Harlem Girls Softball channel within the half hour.
But we are still broadcasting live, obviously, if you're listening to us, then you're seeing us. But if you want to let your friends know, if they're on netcastsports.com right now and can't find it, you can find us on, if you go to ustream.tv, the letter U-S-T-R-E-A-M, ustream.tv, and just search for Harlem Softball, and we'll come up and be the first one there on the list. Again, tell your friends, ustream.tv, search for Harlem Softball, and we should be the first one on the list. And one pitch, foul back. Please count 1 and 2. This is number 20, the right fielder, Allie Keel. I know it says she's a freshman. She stands in against Amber Garrett. 2 outs and runner on second base. 1-2 pitch. Sails high for ball 2. Foul back. Keels stays alive. And that's Taylor Little out on second base. He singled earlier in the inning. Good, winds up and delivers. Foul back. Freshman has seen a few pitches and staying alive here against Amber Garrett. Taken. Ball 3.
We'll bring it to full count.
It looks like got a very hitter-friendly strike zone working today. Three, 2 pitch. Looking inside, throw down to third, and she is dead in the water. So, freshman Keel walks, but no avail as Little is thrown out, attempting to steal third.
I'd like to thank our sponsors today. John Durst Bread, John Derspread is the proud sponsor of the Harlem Lady Bulldog softball team. They have been so kind as to aid in the Augusta Metro Youth Foundation and Player 360 broadcasting this game to you live.
Leading things off here in the bottom of the second inning for the Harlem Lady Bulldogs is the catcher, number 6, Morgan Barton.
She takes first ball high. Count 1-0.
Morgan is a senior.
Nice cut. Fouled off left. Count 1-1. Another pitch high and outside for ball 2. Hard cut by Miss Barton. A little late on her swing. Foul tipped off.
She got a piece of it. Small piece, but.
Small.
Yeah. She tipped it back, so. There's that changeup we were talking about.
That's right.
Next up for the Lady Bulldogs is going to be number 3, Hannah Price. Foul back for strike number 2.
Swung on and missed for strike 3. That's going to bring the outs to 2. Bottom of the second.
Man, nice. 2 strikeouts this inning, and I believe that's 3 total. Senior shortstop, number 1, Tori Poss.
It's her first pitch for a strike. She watched that one on the outside. Her first ball, count 1-1. All right, she's going to take her base. And that was number 3, Hannah Price.
That was, number 1, Tori Poss.
Sorry about that.
Hannah Price. Maury Barton and Hannah Price allowing back-to-back strikeouts, which brings us to 2 outs. And Tori Poss on first with a walk. And number 4, the center fielder, Christian Mullis at the plate, drills one to right center field over the head of the right fielder. Poss is rounding third. She's going to be waved home to score. And Christian Mullis has a stand-up triple.
She just did find a hole on that hit. I'll tell you what. If it wasn't a few feet further back, it would have been caught.
She did. She said it right over the – and like we said, the wind might be blowing out a little bit of right center field. That could be aiding the hitters tonight. Hey, Mays drops one down the third baseline. Foul. Haley Mays steps in with 2 outs and runner on third.
Coming back to the plate with a count of 0-1. Showing bunt.
Safe. Safe at home, and no one is covering second. Haley Mays takes out for second. The ball gets past the right fielder coming in to cover plate. Haley Mays is going to round third and score.
And she makes a home run off a bunt.
So with Christian Mullis on third with two outs, Haley Mays bunts. No one's covering. No one gets over to cover first in time. There's no play at first. And the pitcher throws home, doesn't get Christian Mullis in time. Mullis scores. And then and with no one covering second, Haley Mays takes off for second base. The throw to second gets past the center fielder who's coming in to cover on the play, and Mays is able to score.
Coach for Bleckley County comes and has a little conference with their team out on the pitcher's mound, probably giving them a little pep talk, telling them to calm down a little bit, get their head back in this game.
Yeah, that's Tennessee sometimes is to you want to throw the ball when something's happening. You want to do something and make a play. But in that situation, probably the best thing for the catcher to do would have been to just hold the ball. The center field was not going to get to the second base in time to get Haley Mays out at second. She wasn't going to be there on time, so that was should have held on to that throw to keep it from advancing to third. Number five, second baseman Abby Drake. Fouls one off the left side.
Another foul back over our heads. Count 0-2. Tell you what, if she gets this timing down a little bit better, I think she's starting to zero in on Bleckley County's pitcher.
That's right.
Another foul off left. Count remains 0-2.
See, getting that ball back in. You see all the infielders there shielding their eyes from the sun. Over kind of behind left field, down by the left field line. Really tough for the first baseman right now. First and second baseman. Up the middle.
Center field easily takes that one down for out three. And we'll be coming into the top of the first here. Top of the third, excuse me. The score 4-0, Lady Bulldogs. I'd like to continue thanking our sponsors, the Augusta Metro Youth Foundation, hosting the Will Avery Fall League every Saturday morning at Evans High School. Come out to Evans High School every Saturday morning at 8 a.m. for skill development for boys and girls of all ages, as well as afternoon league play for high school boys. Katrina Dent Photography. Katrina Dent would be happy to take your session of any and all life
moments. Just special moments. She does weddings, bridal portraits, engagements, maternity pictures, baby pictures, your children, family photos. Check her out, KatrinaDentPhotography.com. Now's a good time. Take the kids out. Take them out to a pumpkin patch or something like that. Get some good holiday photos with your family. KatrinaDentPhotography.com. Leading off things in the top of the third for the Lady Royals is going to be first baseman number one, Kelsey Darcy. She takes the ball high and inside.
Second pitch high and outside.
Yeah, that's two pitches in a row to lead off the inning here that have been high for Amber Garrett. She got a four run lead here in the early going, so she needs to settle down a little bit and go right after these hitters and let her defense back her up out there as grounded to first, and lefty Rollins gobbles it up and on to first for the out. Number five, Nicole Tomlinson, senior designated player, Lady Royals, up to bat. She swings through the first pitch. Pitch shows bunt in the air, diving grab by Lindsay Stokes for out number two. Great reaction by the junior third baseman there. A 1-2 count. It's a strike three for number 10, Elizabeth Mathis. So another 1-2-3 inning for Amber Garrett and the Lady Bulldogs in the top of the third. It is going to be number 14, Lindsay Stokes, leading off the bottom half of the third inning for the Lady Bulldogs. Lindsay with the diving grab in the top half of the inning on a bunt attempt by number 5, Cole Tomlinson for the Lady Royals. Thank you. Stokes homered in her first at bat, and she takes a ball low and outside. Grounded right side and through. Leadoff single for Stokes. She's 2 for 2. Pitcher, freshman number 13, Amber Garrett, stepping up to the plate for the Lady Bulldogs. And she singled to right her first time up. She pops up, foul territory, drops. Dropped by first baseman Kelsey Darcy. As I said, the here we are at 5:42 p.m. in Harlem, Georgia, and the sun is setting, and maybe in the eyes of the on the right side of the infield over there. Stokes takes off for second, but Garrett fouls back out of play. Not making excuses, just telling you the situation. Popped up left side, coming in the left fielder. Not going to get there, and Amber Garrett is going to have a single. Amber Garrett is 2 for 2. She's going to get pinch runner, and that's going to be number 2, Mackenzie Hall. Runners on first and second for number 11, Kristen Rollins, Lady Bulldogs first baseman. Popped up center field. And it's caught. No advance by the runners. Number 6, the catcher, Morgan Barton, coming to the plate with one out. Runners on first and second. Grounded back up the middle, takes a funny bounce past the pitcher. Looks like that went off the end of the bat. It had some serious English on it. For those of you billiards enthusiasts, it had a lot of spin on that ball, and when it hit right in front of the pitcher, it just cut hard to the left, to her right, and out of reach. But the shortstop was able to come in and make the play. Both runners advance. So, Stokes on third, Hall, Kinsey Hall, pinch running for Amber Garrett, out on second for number 3, designated player, Hannah Price. Takes the ball inside to even the count. Strike 2. Ball high, evens the count. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Runners on second and third. Hannah Price at the plate. Takes called strike 3 on the outside corner. Harlem fans might hold that that was the outside corner of the batter's box, but it was ruled to be the outside corner of the plate. So in the bottom of the third, Lady Bulldogs now in a threat, get runners to second and third, but not able to cross the plate. Harlem maintains a 4-0 lead going into the top of the fourth inning. To Lindsay Dabbs, leading things off for the Lady Royals, and she swings through strike number one. Lindsay is the senior center fielder in tonight's game. Grounded to second and first at bat. Grounds one to third, Stokes hauls it in, and the stretch by Rollins at first for out number one. Left fielder, number 14, Emmy Meadows, comes to the plate with one out. Emmy struck out in her first at bat. Takes the ball high inside. Popped up, but foul. Now boy. Ball low, brings the count to 2-1. Garrett lines up and delivers. Grounded foul to even the count at 2-2. Pitch to Meadows. Changeup taken high. Ball three. She thought about it. Thank you. going to be the pitcher, number three, Joanna Knight, coming to the plate for the Lady Royals. Here with two outs in the top of the fourth inning. The last at bat, Knight struck out, leading off the second inning. Swung on a miss for strike number three. The sixth strikeout for Harlem pitcher Amber Garrett. Going to be shortstop number one, Tori Poss, leading off the game for the Bulldogs. Poss, that's one foul, out of play to even the count at 1-1. Decided a little late to swing at that one. She still grounded it to the left side. Foul. Looks like that one might have hit her. She trots down to first base. She's okay. Number four, center fielder Kristen Mullis comes out to the plate. Last time she tripled to right field. Lays a bunt down the left field line, and she's on the first in time. So, a bunt infield single for Kristen Mullis. She's 2-for-2. Haley Mays comes to the plate with two on. Haley in her last at bat. scored on a bunt. She bunted and made it all the way around back to home plate. She lays him down, bounce back foul.
Now, Haley Mays had a little help on that bunt home run.
Oh, yeah.
From Bleckley's overthrow on second.
That's right.
Another bunt, foul back. It's going to bring the count to 0-2.
Yeah, she's getting a little bit ahead of herself here. Want to take off at first before she's got the bunt down. Got to lay it down first. She lays down, going back to the pitcher.
And the pitcher can't make up her mind to where to throw. So we're looking at bases loaded
for number 5, second baseman, Abby Drake.
We have no outs and Lindsey Stokes on deck.
He fouls one off her leg. Pitch taken, ball high.
Count 1-1.
Strike.
Hearing a lot of opposition from the fans there.
Yeah, they popped up. Foul territory, first base side. But Kelsey Darcy hauls that in. So.
It's going to be out number one against the Lady Dogs. Lindsey Stokes steps up the plate with bases loaded. Now, I think round one of Region 3 AA play is coming to mind in this situation right here.
Stokes has a home run and a single so far tonight. Got Tori Poss on third, Kristen Mullis on second, and Haley Mays on first. Ripped up the middle and caught. Kristen Mullis is going to be doubled off second. And an inning-ending double play. Stokes ripped that one, but center fielder had her played well and came in, was able to make a diving stop, and Mullis got a little too far off second base and was doubled off.
Fortunately, the Lady Dogs are not able to capitalize on bases loaded, and four remains. Lady Bulldogs 4, luckily counting 0. Resolve the issues with the video stream. If you're watching us at home, you're back on the Harlem Softball Channel for Player 360. Apologize for that little bit of technical snafu. Top of the fifth, Taylor Little for Bleckley County coming to the plate.
She's a catcher, number 8. She singled to left in her first at bat. Little swings through a strike.
Count one and one.
Green lines up and delivers. Strike. Little is going to switch back to the right-handed batter's box. She thought that pitch was a little inside, but she was taking off the first and kind of stepped in towards the plate, moving around a lot there in the batter's box. She takes strike number three. Yep. Strike three.
It's like the change of perspective didn't help her much.
No. That is the seventh strikeout. And yeah.
Number 15, Leslie Holland, second base for Bleckley County, takes her first pitch as a strike. Count 0-1. And we've got strike two against Ms. Holland for Bleckley County, bringing the count to 0-2. Hangs in there with a foul, left side. So Leslie Holland had a little dribble up to the pitcher and her last at bat thrown out at first. She's hanging in there with count 0-2. Pitch outside. Be her first ball, count 1-2.
Taking a look at the bracket here. Bleckley County swept Thomasville in round one to advance here to round two.
Pitch comes in high. Count will move to 2-2.
Winner of this series will advance to the Elite Eight. And I believe the winner of the series will face off against the winner of Jeff Davis and Crawford County.
Ball comes in low and in the dirt. It's going to be full count now against Ms. Leslie Holland for Bleckley County.
Looking at a copy of the bracket here on GeorgiaPrepCountry.com. That's GA.PrepCountry.com. Those of you at home interested want to take a look at the bracket and find some stats.
Number Garrett throws in a fastball that's fouled back. Count remains 3-2. Another foul tip.
Let's see here in the last week in the first round of the AA state playoffs. Bleckley County defeated Thomasville 7-0 in game one and 22-7 in game two. So far, Lady Bulldogs held them scoreless through 4 1/3.
Going to call that ball low. She will take her base. Number 20, Allie Keel to the plate now for Bleckley County. Her last at bat, she was put a bunt down. Was out of it. Pitch straight down the middle for strike one.
She is the freshman right fielder. Shows bunt, fouled, right side, out of play.
Count comes 0-2. One out now against Bleckley County. Swung on late, fouled off. Hanging in there, count 0-2.
Leslie Holland is on first base with a walk. Lines up and delivers. Pops up right side. That's going to get down. Hayley Mays comes in and fields cleanly. Fields ball cleanly, and Leslie Holland advances to second on the play. So Leslie Holland, second baseman number 15 out at second base. Number 20 right fielder Allie Keel at first. Brings to the plate first baseman number 1, Kelsey Darcy. She takes strike number 1. Darcy, in her last at bat, grounded out to first. She's batting with one out in the top of the fifth inning. Yeah, lines up, delivers, lays down a bunt, fielded by Rollins over to first. Hits the base runner, and she is out. That's gonna be interference on the runner. So Darcy lays down a bunt and is hit in the back with a throw. So she's called out on interference. Running down the first baseline, there's that little extra box in chalk or paint, whatever it's put down there with these days, chalked out on the right side in the foul territory. So when you make it down that far where that box is, that is your running lane. Runner has to be in that lane, and there you see the orange base that's over there too. That is the runner's lane to run in. And so she was not over there. She was running down the she was inside the line in fair territory. And so when that ball, when the throw hit her in the back, she was in not in that running lane. She was in the baseline, and so that's why she was called out. And the runners that were on first and second and had advanced to second and third had to return.
Count moves 0-2 with another fastball swung on and missed.
It's number 5, Nicole Tomlinson. Her last time up, she bunted, laid down a bunt and popped it up to third, and Lindsay Stokes made that diving play. She swings 3-1 high and out of the zone. So Amber Garrett gets in a little bit of trouble with two runners on, but she climbs the ladder to get Nicole Tomlinson for out number 3. That brings her strikeout total to 8 so far through 5 innings. So we'll head to the bottom half of the 5th inning. And it will be number 13, Amber Garrett, the pitcher, will lead things off. See Amber Garrett over there getting some encouragement from her teammates before she goes up to bat. Coach Michael Everett providing instruction.
I'd like to thank Augusta Overhead Door for providing our center field cam platform. They were nice enough to provide a lift for us so that we could get over that outfield fence.
Hey, look at that guy.
That's a good-looking guy right there on the outfield.
That's me. Yeah, that's me out there positioning the lift out there in center field. So thanks again to Overhead.
Amber Garrett with a huge hit over the fence off the top of a truck. You know that guy's
watch
happy.
Watch out left field there.
Jared, we talked a lot about pitchers wanting to prove themselves on the batter's box, and I think we just saw it there.
She has done it. Freshman Amber Garrett has struck out 8 batters so far this game and has delivered all the offense she's needed thus far on the home run. We have a lot of fans. In the back of pickup trucks, it's Kristen Rollins grounds through the right side. She has a single. But making the turn, runs into the first baseman. They're both tripped up on the play. She goes to second. Not sure if she's given the base or not. And as she's running second, a throw is made, and she takes a late slide and is hit up high with the tag. But she's going to be safe at second, whatever the ruling may be. Even if she wasn't awarded the bag, the ball was dropped on the tag. So even if she's not awarded the bag for interference by the first baseman being in the run lane, then she made it in safely anyways because the throw was done.
The coach for Bleckley County clearly not agreeing with the call out on the field.
Yeah,
now
she's talking over with the umpire, trying to get some kind of explanation as to what's happening.
Morgan Barton off to bat. Catcher for the Lady Bulldogs.
As we were saying, a lot of fans setting up behind the outfield fence and the beds of pickup trucks. Great view of the game out there. But heads up, make sure you pay attention.
Got some ringers on the Harlem Lady Dogs that have been waking them up.
That's right.
For sure. All right, we have the first pitch fouled off by Miss Barton. Count 0-1.
Yeah, Stokes has homered. Garrett has homered. And Kristen Mullis put a charge into one that went deep into the right center field gap. But didn't make it out, but it was she hit it high and deep. So
Kristen Barton swinging on the pitch for strike three. That'll bring first out against the Lady Dawgs, top of the sixth.
Number three, Hannah Price, coming to the plate. Hannah Price, the designated player. She fouls one on the right side.
Correction, I apologize. Bottom of the fifth inning here at the Harlem Lady Dawg softball.
Price has stands in with one out and runner on second in the form of Kristen Rollins. Price is the designated player. Any of you out there not familiar with girls softball, as a pickoff attempt is made and Rollins is back safely, there is a designated player and a flex player. The flex player is a foul back out play as a defensive player only. This game for the Bulldogs, Emily Applin, number 12, is our flex player out in left field. And Hannah Price, number 3 at the plate right now, is the designated player who is serving basically sort of like a designated hitter.
Count 2-2.
After each pitch, lefty's been getting a good lead off of second, making the staring down the catcher. Taylor Little making her think about it. She's drawn the throw once already. That's what your runners with speed will do for you. They'll be out there and toying with the catcher, toying with the pitcher, trying to cause a distraction out there and hopefully draw a throw and maybe draw a bad throw and be able to advance. Price takes strike three for out number 2. Shortstop, number 1, Tori Poss, coming to the plate. She was hit by a pitch in her last at bat.
Watches a ball outside for her first ball, count 1-0. Second pitch also outside, ball 2. Looked like a little off-speed pitch there. Caught her up. Count 2-1. Bring the count to 3-1.
Joanna Knight's pitching a good game for the Royals. There's been
Ooh, another
she's hit.
Hit
again.
That's twice.
Poss has been hit now. Second time. Knight's been pitching a pretty good game so far. There's been a few defensive miscues and, of course, giving up the long ball a couple of times to Stokes and Garrett. But several of the Lady Dawgs pitchers have not been able to figure her out. She has 6 strikeouts. Wrong. Does Knight. Poss gets checked out by her first base coach after being hit for the second time, and she's okay. Rollins on second, Poss on first for center fielder number 4, Kristen Mullis. She lines one back up the middle. That's going to get through. Rollins makes a turn. She's trying to score at home. Third comes in at the plate, and she is out. Good base running effort by Rollins, but the ball just it was hit hard and wasn't deep enough for her to be able to score from second on that play. But Lady Bulldogs do pick up one in the bottom of the fifth on the Amber Garrett home run. It brings them to a 5-0 lead heading into the top half of the sixth inning. Thanks again to Sunrise Grill, two locations in Martinez and North Augusta. Check them out at thesunrisegrill.com.
Mark Whitaker with Whitaker Electric Company Incorporated. Give Mark Whitaker a call for all your residential, commercial, industrial electrical needs. Number 10, Elizabeth Mathis for Bleckley County up the bat.
She's a shortstop, leadoff hitter. Freshman. She grounds back up the middle to Garrett. Garrett over to first. Rollins grabs it for out number one. Morgan Barton backing up that play all the way down to first base. Great effort by catcher being in the right place. That's showing a lot of hustle. Barton struggled a little bit at the plate this game, but you see her being really strong defensively, showing a lot of hustle, giving a lot of effort. So. Making up for it on the defensive side, and that's what you want out of your players. You're not gonna nature of this game. You're not gonna hit the ball every time, but you want to see them working hard.
Number two, Lindsay Dabbs up to bat.
Grounds the short, Poss over to first in time for out number two.
Great throw by Poss.
Quick two outs here in the top of the sixth inning. Going to bring to the plate number 14 left fielder Emmy Meadows.
With two outs against Bleckley County, top of the sixth.
Emmy is 0 for 2 with two strikeouts tonight. See if she's got Garrett figured out yet. She grounds third base side. Stokes comes in and grabs the ball. As it bounces foul.
She's definitely got some wheels. She was on first base before that ball got into Lindsay Stokes' glove.
Pitch from Garrett. Taking the ball high.
Count one and one. Pitch low. Count two and one. Bit of an inside pitch that's going to bring the count to 3-1.
Garrett gets her side. Lines up and delivers. Grounded left side. Foss takes it. Funny Hopkins.
Another rope by Foss.
Yeah. Yeah, that one could have easily eaten her up over there short as it it took a short hop on her, but she came up with it cleanly and over to first and time for that. So three ground outs here in the top of the Royals sixth inning.
We've seen some great pitching from both sides of the field here today, but I'll tell you what, that defense from the Harlem Lady Dogs has just been backing up their pitcher.
Rock solid tonight. We mentioned one of our sponsors, Sunrise Grill. Remind you, they are at 3830 Washington Road in Martinez, Georgia, and 404 East Martintown in North Augusta, South Carolina. Visit KatrinaDentPhotography.com. Check out her blog, Facebook page. You can see some examples from her portfolio. Katrina Dent Photography. Weddings, bridals, engagements, family pictures, children, teens, babies, maternity. Capture all your family special moments.
Number nine, Haley Mays to the plate. Shows bunt, bunts up to the pitcher. Pitcher makes throw and is safe at first. Haley Mays with an excellently placed bunt and the speed to get her to first safely.
Yeah. Only made it to first this time. Didn't make it all the way around.
That's
the
right.
Score.
I know she's a little disappointed in that one.
Mays takes off for second. Great throw. Catcher Taylor Little is going to be in time. Number five, second baseman Abby Drake.
Watches that first pitch hit that outside corner for strike one.
This is, I think the ground of the short.
Bobble by the shortstop is going to make it easier at first.
Bobble couldn't come up with it. Excuse me, Mathis. Mathis at short couldn't come up with it.
Up the bat.
That is following at short. Lineup we get from coach says Holland is it. He's playing second, but that is Holland over at short.
Pitch inside. Lindsay narrowly gets missed by that one. Ball one.
Stokes is 2-for-3 tonight. She has a home run and a single. In her last at bat, she hit the ball hard, line drive up the middle, but a great play by Lindsay Dabbs, the center fielder for the Lady Royals. Came in, double. She grounds hard to short. Drake is called out at second on the fielder's choice. Disagreement from the Bulldog fans.
Number 13, Amber Garrett back up to the plate. Her last at bat was a home run across left field fence. Watches her first pitch as ball one, count 1-0. Second pitch low, ball two. Count 2-0, two outs here against the Lady Dogs with Lindsay Stokes on first Outside corner caught for strike one, count 2-1. I think the fans might have thought the first baseman came off the bag on that one. But they're calling her out for out three, and they will switch it up here. Top of the seventh. Score remains Lady Dogs 5, Bleckley County 0.
Okay. I got to figure it out now. The Lady Royals roster is a little, their lineup was off from what I'm seeing in the field. They may have switched around a little bit. It is number 10, Elizabeth Mathis, is at third. Number 15, Leslie Holland, is at short. And at second base is number 19, flex player Allison Collins. My apologies to Elizabeth and Leslie and Allison.
I'm joined by Drew Eubanks here, guest commentator for the Player 360 broadcasting. What are you thinking about the game so far, Drew?
I mean, it's going well. It's the seventh inning. If they can hold this five-run lead, they'll be ending this game and heading to the second one.
That's right. If we can get some three up, three down, we might be going to the second game a little early.
Oh, yeah. But, yeah, one thing I was impressed with was Lindsay Stokes' last bat. I mean, you could tell on her face she was a little aggravated by how the pitcher was throwing kind of close to her, but then she calmed down. You know, previous time when we talked to the coach, he said sometimes she'd be reaching or she was just swinging because she was aggravated, but you could tell on her face she calmed down. She swung and got a base hit, but, you know, can't remember. I think it was Drake that got out second, but it was pretty neat to see that.
She's showing her skills on the mound right now with second pitch is strike two. That's going to bring the count to 0-2 against number 3, Joanna Knight for Bleckley County. Pitch a little high.
Yeah, a little high.
It's going to bring count 1-2.
1-2. You know, Jared's actually off real quick. He does a pretty good job on his commentating. Remember a few games back, we asked him something about the Braves, and he just would not stop talking about it.
Yeah, I mean, don't know why that is. You might think he's a Braves fan or something.
Yeah, I know, right? I mean, I think he went on 3 innings talking about one play. I mean, it was a very important play. Don't get me wrong, but it was just funny to hear him talk about it.
I'll tell you, his knowledge of baseball is not to be doubted at all. But
exactly. Yeah, I thought it was funny.
Ember Garrett with the pitch, grounded to third. Lindsay Stokes makes a throw.
And
gets
out.
Gets her on first.
Awesome.
Great throw by Lindsay.
Earlier when we got here and we finished unpacking his car and moved up, he's like, hey, Drew, which hat do you think I should wear today? I'm like, really? And but yeah, he has his green jacket's hat on today because it's a local baseball. His choices were, I think, the Braves and his Clemson hat, but I think he made a good choice.
Channeling his baseball fan.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Fouled back, ball 1, strike 1.
With a foul, became a strike. Ooh, another foul. I think it went in the exact same place. Hopefully it's not hitting our cars back there.
All right, I believe the count is actually 0-2 now, with two foul balls back. Out one against Bleckley County. Amber Garrett getting a little encouragement from first baseman number 11, Kristen Rollins. Fast nice. Pitch down the middle, strike three.
Yeah, that's something I've noticed, us filming Harlem, and is that the team motivates each other, like all the players. It's amazing to see that in the team, because sometimes, there might be, I don't know, people not getting along, but I have not seen one player.
Yeah, they definitely don't get frustrated with one another. You see a lot of encouragement. Number 15, Leslie Holland at the plate now for Bleckley County. Going to take her first strike on the outside corner.
Yeah, even when they make a mistake or anything, they're all going to encourage each other, not, sit there and get on to each other, but definitely encouragement. Hit the second and out. And it looks like this game
is number 5, Abby Drake at second base.
And I believe
that hit, that could have gotten away from her. Usually a good bounce on that, that hit, bounce. But she came up clean and threw out the first. That's going to bring game 1 to a close. Harlem Lady Dogs winning with 5 runs, 2-0.